Well, the first thing I did right was the day I started to fight. Keep your eyes on the prize and hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Keep your eyes on the prize and hold on, hold on.
As I look back, as I said, at the evolution of our foundation, it wouldn't have happened in the way it did if it not had been for our collaboration with the Liberty Hill Foundation. Power comes from communities. It comes from the communities we work in. And that should compel everyone in philanthropy to invest in movement building and leadership development. And again, I know that's the work of the Liberty Hill Foundation. And quite frankly, it should be the work of all philanthropy.
Thank you, Liberty Hill, for everything you are to Los Angeles. I also want to say thank you for recognizing in the introduction, in the memoriam, our director of organizing, Antonio Bernabe, who passed this year of COVID. He was incredibly in love with Liberty Hill because he really saw that Liberty Hill supported the organizing and the leadership development of the human beings who we are fighting for and with. You become a better organizer when you surround yourself with the people who are directly impacted, but also by the organizer, sustain this fight, and that you listen a lot and you understand that they have a lot to teach.
Thank you to Liberty Hill for everything you do, and especially the incredible work on the ground in LA that you support. You support the work that is the roots of every effective movement for change that's going to change our country and create the multiracial democracy and economy that we deserve. And groups like the National Domestic Workers Alliance wouldn't exist were it not for Liberty Hill. A number of our founding organizations were LA kick-ass, badass women organizers. And that's why I'm here. That's why we're here. That's why we've been able to win. So I just want to say everyone who supported Liberty Hill should be so proud. We are resilient and we are powerful. And the heartbreak reminds us that we are alive and we are still here and we are here for each other. And we are powerful together. And our job as organizers is to expand the realm of what's possible. And the heartbreak gives us new insight into how we can and must do that.
You know, the Liberty Hill model affirmed this idea that we could do community-centered philanthropy is also the foundation and part of the shaping in my mind of the creation of my own organization, Black Voters Matter. Your impact on the shaping of my work in this space of at the intersection of social justice, of philanthropy, right, and community of power building, that at that sweet spot, you know, I think Liberty Hill has been a model that many of us have drawn from, that many of us actually still admire, that many of us actually continue to support. This is a moment for us not to like chill away and want to just cover up and put another Band-Aid over the pain that has been systemic for centuries in this country. But it's time for us to really, really get to the source of it and uproot it so we can literally treat the real ailment of structural racism in this country.